Generic and non-generic collections. What do they mean and what is the difference between both? Let's learn more about both in this video. Generic and non-generic collections in .NET differ in their ability to hold elements of specific types. Let's begin by understanding the generic collection. Generic collections allow you to define collections that hold elements of a specific type. They provide type safety and compile time type checking, ensuring that you can only insert elements of the specified type. Some examples of generic collections include List of T, a dynamic sized list that can hold elements of type T. For example, List of Int can hold integers, List of String can hold strings, and so on. Dictionary of T key T value, a collection that stores key value pairs, where T key represents the type of the keys, and T value represents the type of the values. For example, Dictionary of String Int can hold key value pairs with strings as keys and integers as values. Hash set of T, a collection that stores unique elements of type T. For example, hash set of string can store a set of unique strings. Now let's shift our focus to the non-generic collection. Non-generic collections do not have type-specific constraints and can hold elements of any type. They are less type-safe because the type checking is deferred until runtime. Some examples of non-generic collections include ArrayList, a collection that can store elements of any type. For example, it can hold integers, strings, or even objects of custom types. HashTable, a collection that stores key value pairs without type constraints. Both keys and values can be of any type. DataTable, a tabular representation of data that can hold columns of different types. Each row in the data table can contain data of various types. This was the meaning of both collection types. Now choosing between generic and non-generic collections depends on the specific requirements and context of your application. If you know the specific type of elements you need to store, and want type safety and compile time checks, generic collections are recommended. On the other hand, if you have a collection with elements of different or unknown types, non-generic collections provide more flexibility but at the cost of type safety. It is generally recommended to use generic collections whenever possible due to their type safety and improved performance. That's all you have to know for now.